Hi friends, David here from Learn Stage Lighting, and in this video, I'm really pumped, really excited to continue talking about lasers. And in this video, we're going to talk about probably the most confusing thing about lasers. How do you get control of them? If you've worked with lasers before, maybe you've seen laser guys with these huge cables, with these thick printer connectors, you know, like we used to use for printers back in the day on computers, and think to yourself, well, how in the world could I ever control this stuff? Clearly, it's only for the laser guy to control. And that doesn't have to be the case. We can, actually, in today's modern day, get control of lasers from DMX, but that's also not always the best solution. So in this video, I want to talk about a few things. First, I want to talk about kind of the why. Why DMX doesn't really work that great for lasers all the time. But then I want to talk about the how. How can we get control of lasers? How can we get control of them via DMX? And what are the pros and cons to each method? I want to get into some of the basics of this. Of course, like anything with lasers or control, this can be a deep well that you dive into. And you can spend years researching this stuff, but let's keep it simple for the sake of this video. When it comes to controlling lasers, a lot of the difficulty comes into the fact that a laser is kind of a hybrid of a light and a video projector, right? Because it can shoot out beams, it can shoot out cool aerial effects, things like that. You can put different patterns per se onto a laser and control it via DMX. But lasers are capable of so much more, and they can do a lot more for our shows, such as displaying text, such as, doing pictures, making drawings, animations, and having different visual effects throughout the air. And these various type of highly customizable effects aren't exactly easy to make with DMX. If you think about it, if you're controlling something like a moving light or an LED par or something like that, there's a limit to how many things you can control, and it's generally pretty low, right? Even the most complex moving heads with gobos and things, you know, come in around 30 to 45 channels. Sure, as we have LEDs and stuff that have a lot of different cells, we get higher channel counts, but for a single head or a single pixeled light, there's only so many things that it can do, and so we can fit it into a fairly finite number of DMX channels. With lasers, it's different, right? Because we can display anything on this laser in a variety of different ways. And so, at the very base level, we've got different lasers here, and I've got some in front of me. You can take a basic laser, like this is X-Laser's Aurora Caliente. You can take it, and it's a DMX-controlled laser. Now, this is a pretty simple laser, and the DMX control of it is also simple as well. And so, the general gist here is, while a lot of lasers aimed at the stage can be controlled by DMX, there's going to be a limit as to what you can do. Now, with something like this Caliente Aurora, it's a simple scanning laser that just does horizontal things, and so you're able to crack open a lot of the functionality that it has within 10 DMX channels. You can turn on the different colors on and off, you can choose different patterns, you can set some speeds on things, and truth be told, if X-Laser were to open up a more complicated way to control this thing, you wouldn't really be able to do a ton more with it. So for a simple laser like this, DMX works really well. Not only that, of course, with anything in control, the less options that you have to control, the quicker it will be to program it, right? The less rabbit holes you can get down, etc. But if we're using lasers in our show, chances are we want something more complex. We want more complex control, that ability to completely customize what we're going to do. And so there's a couple avenues to get there, okay? The most old school way of doing things is like with this X-Laser Mercury laser. It's got what's called an ILDA port on the back, okay? That's what they're called. It's this big old serial port, looks like something that you used to control a printer with, like I said. And it's an analog type control system that allows you to do pretty much anything that the laser can do. Now, ILDA is controlled via programs like Pangolin's Quick Show and Beyond. Okay, those are two very popular programs for this. And like controlling other media from a lighting console, controlling lasers via this program kind of works the same way. You set up inside of your program, your Quick Show or Beyond, different looks that you want to do with your laser, different animations, different controls, etc. And then you can map those via DMX. You can control the ILDA software from DMX. Then the ILDA software has a USB to ILDA box, similar to like a USB to DMX box, that can then plug into your lasers. And you can then control your lasers effectively by DMX, but through the ILDA software. Now, how this really helps you and makes things easier is that the software for controlling lasers is designed to control lasers. So when you want to make text, resize things, move things around, and do so quickly, it's a really great option for highly customizable needs, okay? I've watched laserists on ILDA before take some simple lettering, customize the font, add in some company logos, and then on site, quickly with a corporate backdrop on the wall, go ahead, resize everything, skew it, make it match perfectly, and be done in just a few minutes. It's very quick, okay? It can be. Now, the downsides to this, of course, is ILDA cables are thick and huge and kind of a pain to deal with. And also, you may not want to integrate another program in. Now, another really interesting laser control that we talked about before and we'll continue to talk about here is LaserOS. Now, LaserOS works with this guy, the Lasercube, but there's also the LaserOS dongle that you can get, which allows you to use any ILDA laser with the LaserOS software. But these Lasercubes, these units that we've talked about and I've reviewed here, we can check out that video here. These guys connect via USB to an Android device, Windows, or Mac. And through LaserOS, you're able to go ahead and get that same kind of control via that ILDA would have, but without the thick, expensive cables. And honestly, I've never found an easier way to control these things. When I first got this guy in the mail, this Lasercube, and started using it, I was amazed at how quickly I could get up and running, animations, pictures, etc. I could make things in LaserOS. There's a lot of pre-built content. And so LaserOS is a really great way to control lasers because it's quick, it's easy to get started, and it's able to work with a variety of lasers. Now, the downside being, of course, you've got to have a Lasercube or an ILDA-based laser with that Lasercube, with that LaserOS dongle. Okay, another downside of LaserOS is that it's very easy to use, which means, generally, and it's true in this control application as others, because it's easy to learn, it can't do all of the complex things super fast that you might be trying to customize text exactly. Its software is not really built to do that, but it is really powerful and can do some really cool stuff. Also, when I first reviewed this Lasercube, I went ahead, set up the program Show Cockpit to translate DMX into MIDI to be able to control LaserOS from a DMX console. But I've been talking with the developers, and it sounds like if not by the time this video comes out, there should soon be DMX integration into LaserOS. Now, there's another way to control lasers, which is even easier, and could do everything you need, okay? And these are systems to control lasers like moving lights. Now, X-Laser has theirs, and it's called Mercury. And this laser that I've got here, this Skyrider M2, it has Mercury within it. Now, the cool thing about Mercury, and there's one called FB4 from one of the other big laser manufacturers, and there may be other ones out there as well. But the cool thing about these type systems is they basically take a laser and they break it down so that it controls like a stage light. So in the case of Mercury, while you're not able to customize exact strings of text and things like that, there are literally hundreds of pre-built effects, basically gobos as they translate into lighting console knowledge, that you can select via Mercury. Then you get the other parameters that you're used to working with in lighting. And it's really, really powerful. Not only that, you get multiple layers of effects that you can stack upon each other. And so the way that a system like Mercury works, and it works really well, is that you basically go ahead and build different looks together that you might use during different portions of, say, a given song, okay? Then you can bring up the intensity of all these different layers within the laser at different times, okay? Not only do you have intensity control, but you have pan and tilt control, and you can apply different colors and different prisms and other similar effects over top of this laser. And so the possibilities really with a system like Mercury are endless. You can't do like exacting text and things like that. That's where if you need like exacting graphics, exacting text, and you want to throw that in quick and be able to build that stuff, then you might want to use ILDA control. But if you're looking for basically a laser in a pretty typical stage lighting setup where you're making beam effects, you're shooting some basic patterns, and you want to do some really cool looking stuff, but it doesn't have to be like overly representational, as we used to say in art class, then you really want to look hard at a system like Mercury. Because rather than having an extra program that interfaces, these interface directly with your lighting console and are able to be controlled by your console. And that's really cool stuff, okay? And you can get a lot out of them. You know, with Mercury, I've been looking with it and working with it, and you can even work with it inside of visualizers with their tool Accelerate. And this isn't a commercial, by the way. They sent me this laser to use, but it's not, they didn't pay me to make this video. I just think it's really interesting. With Mercury, you can basically build different almost spot portions where you have different lights all within one light. And you can have multiple beams coming out of one laser. So it can get really powerful. Okay, guys? Now with that, guys, I'm going to stop here. This is a lot of info, I know, especially if you're new to this. Controlling lasers can seem complex. But hey, we've got more videos here this month on the Learn Stage Lighting YouTube right here on lasers. So subscribe here for me. That helps a lot. And check out the rest of the videos in our lasers playlist. And come back next week where we're going to keep talking about great ways to use lasers in your show. I'll see you guys there. Thanks.